All right, so here's my first ride slash review of the brand new 2017 Ducati Supersport. And the reason I'm doing it as a voiceover is because when I filmed this, I was extremely hungover.
I gotta quit drinking before I do these. For real.
I couldn't concentrate on talking and writing, but you know, a couple Apple Martinis will do that to you, right? But don't worry, you will have plenty of opportunities to hear the exhaust when I floor it throughout this entire video. So me and my buddy Eric decided to find out what this bike was all about, and I think he liked it a lot more than I did. I liked the bike, but I struggled to really want it, and here's why. Ducati advertised this as a bike that blends comfort with versatility. Now that sounds wonderful, but the truth is, it's not much more comfortable than the 959 Panigale, or any other super sport for that matter.
Sounds epic.
And it's not as comfortable as most sport tourers. You know, for example, the Versys, the S1000 XR, the Ninja 650 1000, you know, the upright versions, or any kind of standard or naked bike. Now, although the seat is very plush and it feels like you can sit on it for hours, I definitely wouldn't take this bike on a trip that's over 400 miles. It's just not comfortable enough for that. So it doesn't quite fit in with serious sport tours as far as riding position and comfort. But it does have some good points that those bikes don't have. So it's not all doom and gloom. I could easily flat foot at stoplights, even being just 5'9 and a half. Now, Ducati say they will sell you different seats depending on your ride height preference. Very cool, so you can customize it all you like. The bike is also fitted with an adjustable windscreen, which raises up and down 50 millimeters, which didn't seem to do anything at all. You can duck behind it, but you can also do that on superbikes, so I don't really see the point of that. And superbikes don't have adjustable windscreens. You're probably, but Ben, what about the performance? This is a Ducati. It must perform. And yes, they have armed this bike with a wonderful power plant. Ducati reports 113 horsepower at 9,000 RPMs, which is plenty. At no point did the bike feel slow, and that's majorly to do with the torque, actually. Ducati claimed 71 foot-pounds of torque at 6,500 RPMs. But the amazing part is, you get 80% of the available torque at just 3,000 RPMs. That's practically idling. And you can definitely feel this when you're riding the bike. The bike is no slouch. Now this bike isn't geared like a normal street bike. First gear seems quite tall, and the rest of the gears feel shorter than normal. I'm guessing to make it easier to use around town or in parking lots, whatever. One feature I'm glad this bike doesn't have is engine heat. I felt none at all, even at stoplights, which was a revelation. I wanted to scream to other motorists, "They've done it! Finally! My legs aren't hot!" Hopefully, this is a glimpse of Ducatis to come. Now you're probably thinking, but Ben, I can't afford the maintenance on a Ducati. Well, Ducati have thought of that too. With increased service intervals, now oil changes are done at 9,000 miles and valves every 18,000 miles. So you spend more time riding and less time at the shop. That's a win.
Oh no, you don't.
The engine is real smooth and this bike feels like a real quality item. It feels expensive, which surprisingly, it isn't. At $12,995 MSRP, it's only a grand more than a Honda CBR 600. And which one is more powerful? This one is! The Ducati, this one! And this sounds a whole lot better than the Honda. And it's exotic. It's not like you don't get any technology for that price either. This comes standard with ABS and traction control. It also sports three riding modes. Another interesting feature is the average speed gauge on the instrument cluster, which tells you how fast you've been going over a given time. Now that's just a recipe for disaster, as I already feel tempted to see how high I can get it. I don't know about you, but showing up to a bike meet on a Ducati sounds a lot better than a Honda. And nothing against Honda, but Ducati's got a better ring to it. Now let's finish up with the styling. This bike looks beautiful, sporting a single-sided swing arm, LED lights, big Brembo calipers, and a sleek Acura exhaust. Although it looks good, it doesn't look as good as its older brothers, the 959 and 1299. It seems like this version has a less aggressive or feminine look to it, and that could be to attract more female riders. So let's circle back to a verdict. If it was my money and I was walking into the shop today, I would not buy this bike. I know the 959 is $3,000 more, but I feel like you get so much more for that chunk of money. You get way more power, better styling. That bike is movingly gorgeous. I feel if I was going to do any kind of touring, there are so many other bikes that are better suited and a better choice. And for a lot less money as well. And if I'm going to do canyons or track days, I would want a bike more focused. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it was informative. I urge everyone to ride this bike for themselves to make their own decision. This was just my opinion and overview of the bike. Please like and subscribe for regular motorcycle content. Thank you and good night.